Let's speak now to Chor Wyn in London. He is Executive Director of the Burma Human Rights Network. Good to talk to you. This effectively extends the military coup to London, doesn't it? What do you make of it?
Actually, this is slapping on our face, you know, in the middle of the London and in our, and on our soil. This is totally unacceptable. I think, of course, we have to speak at some level to a civilized way to explain this military, you know, regime, that fascist military regime, to tell them this is not Burma, this is London, this is UK, right? So we urge in the UK government, you know, we have to use all possible way to tell them, you know, this is not the right thing to do.
Yeah, because these actions are clearly disrespecting the ambassador, but also the host country, and some kind of challenge, really, to the UK. Do you expect the UK will actually take action?
I think I have a confidence that it is the time to show the muscle, right? Because this is on our soil. I mean, something is the limit, but they have crossed the limit. So we have to tell them that's not going to be, you know, the business as usual, the way they are killing everyday basis in Burma, and showing their, you know, ruthlessness, and the same practice they're doing on our side in UK, that's not going to accept it.
But you make the point of what the military is doing every day in Myanmar itself. It's very likely they think even over here they can act with impunity, isn't it?
Absolutely. And you see that the way they have kicked out the same way they overthrow the democratically elected government in Burma, and the same way we have some problem with the ambassador as well. We have been asking him to clearly declare to join the CDM movement, but he has been, you know, trying to play both sides. But at this stage, the most important thing is he is recognized as an ambassador here, so he should be protected by all the international law.
You will know, of course, that lawyers representing the ousted civilian government have assembled evidence that they say shows the military is guilty of extrajudicial killings and torture since the coup. They're submitting that to the UN. It'll be considered by the UN on Thursday. What chance of meaningful action on that do you think, given the attitude we've already seen of, say, China and Russia on the Security Council?
I think this is a same situation going on. Burma is like a Syria, and ASEAN countries are not going to accept their next door becoming another Syria. And the situation is now, the military is not going to stop their killing spree and the butchering every day. You know, even the 7-year-old child has been shot dead on her father's lap. So the situation of the amount of the brutality and cruelty is not going to stop very soon. So international community is today or tomorrow have to do something. And the problem with the China and Russia here is they are very much taking one-sided and just looking at their own benefits and only their interests. You know, Russia is just crazily looking for to sell their weapons, and China is, you know, blind to just looking their, or other than looking their interests. So they are every day, people has been shot dead on the street every day. And our account in more than 600 people has been already killed, and there are thousands of people has been jailed. So the situation is not that easy inside Burma, because Burma is, remember that Burma is surrounded by the all ethnic arms group, and it is going to explode. It's going to full blown, you know, civil war is going to happen in Burma.
Chor Wyn of the Burma Human Rights Network, thank you.
Thank you very much.